Welcome. This series of detailed videos will describe the entire workflow for modeling a spark-ignited engine with port fuel injection. We will use CONVERGE Studio, CONVERGE's graphical pre- and post-processor, to demonstrate surface preparation for a simplified geometry. Then, we will demonstrate some surface preparation techniques for an engine geometry. Next, we will use CONVERGE Studio to set up the case. After we run the CONVERGE simulation, we will again use CONVERGE Studio to post-process the results. When simulating the engine with CONVERGE, the goal is to accurately model spray, combustion, turbulence, and other physical processes to calculate a time history of the flow field in the cylinder pressure, the exhaust temperature, and other parameters important for engine design. We will assume that you have already installed CONVERGE and CONVERGE Studio and set up the appropriate licenses. For additional help with these steps, please refer to the Getting Started guide available at convergecfd.com. We will also assume that you have already downloaded the simplified shock tube geometry from convergecfd.com/download. The relevant geometry is located in the path listed below. We will also assume that you have already downloaded the SI8 PFI geometry files. The Lecture 3 ICE geometry folder contains several different versions of the geometry from various intermediate steps in the surface preparation and case setup process. You can also find the fully configured geometry and case setup files in the archive listed below. CONVERGE Studio contains modules that you can use to progress through the CONVERGE CFD workflow. Use the case setup module to set up and repair the surface geometry and to configure the input files necessary for a CONVERGE simulation. Use the tools in the geometry doc to prepare the geometry. These tools allow you to create or delete entities, resize or move portions of the surface, repair surface defects, flag boundaries, etc. In the case setup doc, select physical models, define boundary conditions, set up grid control options, specify post-processing parameters, etc. When you finish this process, export input files, including the geometry file, to your case directory for the CONVERGE solver to read. Use the chemistry module to set up and run various tools such as zero and one-dimensional chemistry tools, mechanism reduction, mechanism merge, and mechanism tuning. Use the Congo module to set up files for a Congo genetic algorithm simulation with CONVERGE. This module tracks and coordinates all of your genetic algorithm input files so you can easily design a genetic algorithm case. Use the line plotting module to create and export 2D plots of simulation data. This module reads data from the converge.out files or any other column-based text files. Save your work in this module as a .psp file. You can also use the line plotting module to compare datasets from different simulations on the same plot and plot datasets from multiple output files, such as from several restarts on a single plot. Other features include the ability to calculate fast Fourier transforms of data, apparent heat release rate, and engine work. This module also allows you to visualize output data while a simulation is in progress. In the Post-Processing 3D module, you can convert binary output files from a CONVERGE simulation to a variety of different formats for visualization. These formats include GMV, Field View, TechPlot, ParaView, and more. First, we will demonstrate importing a simple geometry and some basic surface preparation techniques. Open CONVERGE Studio and click the New Project button to open a blank project. We need to load the geometry for this case. CONVERGE Studio requires a triangulated surface with triangles defined by a unit normal and three vertices. This surface geometry can be formatted in one of two ways: an STL file from a CAD program or a properly formatted .dat file that contains the surface geometry data. For this demonstration, we'll use an STL file. Go to File, Import, Import STL, and select the STL file that contains the simple shock tube geometry. Use the automatic and user-specified tolerance fields to combine points that are very close together. Converge Studio will merge two points if their distance is less than the specified tolerance. Merging points will decrease rendering time in Converge Studio, but setting the tolerance too large can result in a defeatured geometry with additional surface errors. If your STL file uses units other than meters, use the Scale From drop-down menu to convert to meters. You can convert units later if you do not know what units the STL file uses. Click Import to load the shock tube geometry into Converge Studio. It may be useful to obtain basic information about your geometry. Verify that the View toolbar and Message Log are displayed. If the View toolbar is not visible, go to View, Toolbars, and check the checkbox next to View toolbar. If the Message Log is not visible, go to View, Output Panes, and check the checkbox next to Message Log. In the View toolbar, click the Geometry Information button. Converge Studio displays information such as triangle, edge, and vertex counts, as well as the dimensions of the geometry in meters in the message log. Next, you can edit various preferences for using Converge Studio by going to Edit, Preferences. Click on the Autosave tab. Here, you can choose the frequency with which Converge Studio will automatically save your progress and the directory in which to store the autosave files. This feature is useful when working with very large geometries. Next, click on the Rendering tab. If you do not have a good video card, you can check the Show Reduced Geometry During Rotation checkbox for faster rendering. Finally, click on the Exporting tab. You have two options for displaying numbers in exported input files. Either set the precision for a floating point number or use scientific notation. Click OK to close this dialog box. On the left side of the screen, you should see the geometry dock. You can use this dock to create, edit, and delete parts of the geometry. If you do not see this dock, go to the View menu and check the Geometry Dock checkbox. In the Geometry Dock, click on the Options button and then on the Mouse tab. Here, you can modify the mouse controls for rotating, panning, and zooming. This concludes the first video. The next video, Configuring Boundaries and Repairing Surface Defects in Converge Studio, will describe setting up boundaries in Converge Studio.